Hi, I'm Imogen and I'm Nikki Wagner's representative.
Hi, I'm Kate Williams and I'm Jackie Dean's representative.
Hi, I'm Ed Brownlee and I'm Jonathan Coleman's representative.
Where are you from, guys?
Christchurch.
Alexandra.
Auckland.
Well, that's a pretty good geographic mix, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And you're having a good time? Enjoying being in Parliament?
Yeah, definitely. Great experience. Meeting a lot of new people, or with sort of same views as you, or different ones, which is even better. Getting arguments going on.
And is it pretty much how you sort of thought it would be like?
Yeah, I think it's almost better, you know, because we're really getting an insight to what's actually happening and not just how the media is portraying them.
It's quite different, isn't it, sometimes? It's quite difficult to get a handle on exactly how the process works until you get in here and see it. How about you? Are you enjoying it?
Yeah, I've really enjoyed it. I think the first 2 days, or first day was kind of slow, but by the time we got around to the second day and general debate, I think everyone was well into it, and
yeah.
It was great fun.
Yeah, we saw a couple of people, or only one or two, yawning in the back benches, which has obviously been a bit of an issue lately with the MPs cutting down on what the media can do. So it's kind of interesting to see that it's not necessarily that easy to stay sharp.
We have long days. We're pushing so much in. You can't expect us to stay alert the whole time.
Exactly.
Yeah, we've just had food, so we're comfortably full, and it's really warm in there with comfy seats. You know, and it's, I tell you, if you're tired, it's quite easy just to slip back. And
what are some of the big issues that you guys have sort of been talking about?
NCA seemed to be hot topic. Yeah, and just a lot of based on what our select committees are, so VZP,
justice system.
So you're all assigned to sort of select committees, are you? So have you been meeting in those this morning, have you?
Yeah,
just a debrief, but yeah, we have been.
So what's the aim? Are you kind of sitting down and talking about stuff and you're trying to come up with a solution or come up with a sort of common agreement or?
Whether it was good or would it, to say just NCA, for example, whether it was a good idea, and if it was not, why is it bad, or how can we improve it, and things like that.
And hearing witnesses.
So, what select committees have you guys been on?
I'm on the government administration one, so the one about student loan and if it's created an unfair burden on New Zealanders.
Oh, okay, and what, have you come up with a kind of a resolution?
It's very interesting because when I went into it, I was very for the student loans, but then when I heard the New Zealand Students Association, they came in and said, the government can afford to pay for all our tertiary education, so sort of swaying towards maybe that now.
It's really
interesting just, hearing all the opinions and having good arguments with people.
Oh, that's
debating.
Cool.
And I'm on the education NCA, was it a good idea? And it's really interesting, everyone agrees that it is better than the old system, it's just a few things that need to be changed.
Yeah. Well, very cool.
I'm on Foreign Affairs, Defence and Trade.
Ah.
We've been looking into why New Zealand hasn't been meeting its aid targets, set up some Millennium Development Goals and that sort of thing.
And so do you have another Select Committee meeting tomorrow morning? Or
We're reviewing the draft reviews.
This afternoon. Yeah. And then I think tomorrow as well? In the morning?
Yeah, I think so.
And then in the debating chamber.
So you're actually going to have some votes on the issues you've been looking at in the debating chamber? Or?
No, I think it's just on the legislative bill that I think we're going on.
Oh, that's pretty cool. And you've obviously spent a bit of time with your MPs, or some of your MPs have been here?
Well, my MP's part of the steering committee, so very, see her quite a lot, she's lovely.
Yeah, they're giving you a bit of a tour, a bit of a look around and stuff like that?
Yes.
Not really.
No, we do tours with everyone else, so
it's
nice to have a good chat with them.
Oh, that's pretty good. And what got you guys interested in, what got you interested in politics?
I like to argue.
Yeah. And to talk and things, but I think maybe the idea of actually being able to change something.
Yeah.
And also just getting involved in things. I think it's just important to do what you can do for your sort of just your peers and maybe your country in a sense as well, just as youth.
That's cool. That's pretty cool. Because sometimes the rest of us, or not the rest of us, but the older generation sees the younger generation as sometimes being a little bit perhaps apathetic or not so interested in politics, but do you think that's not necessarily a fair representation?
No, I actually would agree with that.
Do you?
Because there is a big majority of youth that would not be interested in politics or anything of like this sort.
Mm.
And it's a shame, really, which is why I don't really agree with Vote 16.
Yeah.
I don't agree with that.
Mm. Yeah, because it's, you know, they've got that big gap of people that they can't get, you know, between the 18 to 20 bracket, but, you know, are they expecting to get, you know, a group of people between 16 to 18? They're just going to have that big gap again of people not voting.
Yeah.
So there's just no point bringing in people that, you know, won't vote or do anything.
What do you think, Ed?
I'm somewhat inclined to disagree with what they've said. I don't support voting at 16, but certainly I think a lot of young people have an underlying interest in politics. I'm just saying all politics is local, everything affects them. And it's just a question of whether or not parties and the government can engage. And I think it's something we've been seeing a lot of recently. Particularly National has been able to engage with young people by adopting many of the ways we communicate, I think.
Yeah.
Politics needs to change. We can't simply expect young people to have an interest. There's a real burden on political parties now to engage with a very important constituency.
So, I mean, you kind of think it's great, sort of videos and blogs and that kind of stuff?
Yeah.
The way we communicate is the most important thing.
I think it's not simply in a practical sense, but just the symbolism of that the parties are prepared to adopt new methods of communication, moving away from the old media. Just the fact that they're prepared to engage, I think, is very good.
Well, that's really cool. And where to from here? So you finish off tomorrow, and then you head home, and you have a bit of a debrief or something, or will you talk to your schools or your universities or whatever about things?
I think my school would probably want me to talk about it, and I think Nikki wants me to maybe do a report or speak about it. But in the future, maybe after university, I could see myself in politics, but I want to go into secondary teaching first. And I think a lot of politicians actually go through that route, secondary teaching or some sort of teaching before going to politics, so it's a possibility.
So you're all kind of quite keen on a career in politics, do you think, or an involvement anyway?
Yeah. I mean, definitely an involvement, but it just depends on which way I'd go about that, you know, whether you're actually an MP or go, you know, behind the scenes type of thing, but... No, where that could lead me?
I think it's actually sort of hard for youth these days because the opportunities are endless. We're just offered so much and we can do what we want and we're encouraged to do what we want. And so it's just really hard narrowing down what you want to do.
And, hope you guys have had a really good time here. What's one thing you think you'll take out of this when you go home?
You first.
if I could sum up Youth Parliament in a word, it would be confidence. Not simply just personal confidence and being able to speak, but confidence in the institution of Parliament. I mean, it gets a really hard time, but I've seen everything that goes on here, and it just works, I think. And I'm really confident that maybe if things aren't great now, we can change things.
Well, that's good. That's really good.
Yeah, and I think probably for me, it'd be the knowledge to know how to do something. If I want, you know, if I don't agree with something that's happening in Parliament, or, you know, I do agree and I want to support it, you know, just being able to know that I can help just as an outsider. I do have I can make a difference, even though I'm not directly involved with it.
Just to add on what they've said, also an awareness of how our government works. It's so big. And yeah, it's just an amazing experience.
Oh, thanks very much, guys. That's really good.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.